You just mentioned not taking it for granted and playing with that joy. I looked over at you today, and it looked like you were smiling and laughing and just kind of having a good time on the bench out there with those guys. Did that have to do with Metta? Is there something different about tonight that brought out that joy?
No. Yeah, part of it definitely was for Metta. Absolutely. But it's fun to coach these guys when they're playing the way they've played the last, you know, few weeks. And they're playing with passion, and they're playing to compete. And when that's happening, as a coach, you can sit back and enjoy that, because they're making plays, and you can live with the mistakes. You know, it's when you're making mistakes and not sharing the ball, and you're not playing at a certain level, you know, with a certain level of intensity or a certain level of competitiveness as a group. That it's really frustrating from the coaching chair, but in a way, especially where we're at right now, it's a time like that. You can sit back for a little bit and enjoy the fun that your guys are having.
Luke goes right here. I was just worried about your impressions of the fun of play. It seems like everybody in the arena was wanting Metta to take that last shot. And just, what do you think that kind of just says about him?
Well, that's tricky. I mean, it's, you don't want to disrespect the other team at all, and then that's why Metta did it. I'm kind of the belief system that we also as a team don't want to take a turnover. So if there's under 24 seconds on the shot clock, then 100% don't shoot the ball. But we don't ever want to just take a turnover. But Metta was obviously doing that out of respect for Alvin and for the Pelicans team, which I'm obviously okay with, but it speaks to the person he is. I mean, he's I think his story and where he's come from and who he is now, he's come a long way, and he's a perfect, like I said, he's a perfect example of what pro athletes should be, as far as the way he works, the way he gives back in the community, the way he mentors younger players. He respects the game of basketball, and out of respect, the game was in hand, and he decided not to take a last shot.
When Metta joined the team first time around, it was before sort of the career reinvention, image reinvention. What were sort of your impressions of him and your reaction when you heard he was going to be joining the team?
I was excited. I didn't have to play against him anymore. I really was. I was kind of, hurt with that tour. We were losing Trevor, because we had a bond with Trevor, and we had won. And but when we signed Metta as that replacement, I was excited. I mean, he was one of they took us to seven the year before that year in Houston. And he was a handful to deal with, so the fact we were adding him to the mix was exciting. I was intrigued on how he was as a person, because all I knew was what I didn't know him at all on a personal level, so all I knew is what he had done in the past, what I've heard about him. But I also heard from teammates that he had that he was a great teammate. And he instantly, from day one when he came in, he was all about the team. There was no ego with him. It wasn't any, fighting about, roles or positions or shot attempts. He came in, figured out what we needed the most to win, and he tried to do that to the best of his ability.
He talked about how, if we don't repeat this year, put it on me, it's my fault. He was the only guy on that team who didn't have a ring at that point. Could you sense, I guess, sort of his hyper-awareness of that, him really wanting to fit in?
Yeah, absolutely. Because for a player of his ability and his success he'd had up to that point as a player, for him to come in and be okay with, the triangle offense, and some games not getting many shots at all, some games only scoring 6 points, when he was a guy that could go out and score 38 on any other team in the league on a given night, it was obvious that he felt that pressure, and, from the teammates and coaches, that obviously isn't the case. Whether we win a title or lose a title isn't going to be dependent on just Metta. You need everybody to win. But there was definitely some, especially as we really got to know him, and he became part of the family, like, there was almost a little extra of, like, let's make sure that we, you know, we get one for Metta, too, now that we have this opportunity.
This was your last home game at Staples Center as head coach of the Lakers for your first year rookie year. Was it everything you thought it would be, you know, kind of the coolest after being the head coach here and coming to Staples Center?
It's been an amazing year so far. Obviously, we got one more to go. There's been a lot of ups and downs, roller coasters that I figured were going to happen, but until you go through them, you're not really, you don't really know how to handle that. But it's been a great year working with these guys and watching them grow and building these relationships with these players. Has been a lot. It's been awesome. Yeah.